So when I last saw you, when I last spoke to this audience, we had just introduced the NGE100 power supply, the FPC1000 spectrum analyzer, and the RTB2000. And at that point, I mentioned that we had very deep pipelines and that Rohde & Schwarz was investing holistically into this market. Today, we're back to show you some proof points of what we've been up to for the past year. So I'll pass you off to my colleague, Joel Woodward, my partner in crime. We'll give you an overview of the new oscilloscopes that we've introduced since we last spoke. But it goes deeper than that. Within a couple of weeks, we're going to have a major introduction in our spectrum analyzer division. And I'm quite excited about that. The pipeline and the investments are even deeper than that too. So right now, maybe some visual proof points we would look into would be looking at our web. Our scopes and probes webpage have changed drastically. It's changed drastically since last year. And we've made them far more easier for our customers to find out about our instruments, do comparisons. We've also made it less confusing by removing microsites. You'll see trends happening along those same lines. In addition, we've also invested in different areas that are probably less visual to you, but for our customers and our partners, it shows the investment that Rohde & Schwarz is here for the long term. Investing in our operations, investing in our service, working on how we go to market, the marketing material that we have in place, having demos in hand, having stock on shelves, having the training done by the time we do the launch. You're going to see more and more as we introduce products as getting into working with our partners in alignment with our direct organization.
I always like to think of things from a user perspective. So what a great time to be in the scope market. Every user has another choice that they can evaluate. They don't have to stick with their traditional choice. Rohde & Schwarz now has that entire lineup where they will offer to customers a really compelling choice. 10-bit ADC powers all of these, so 4 times the resolution of a traditional scope, really low noise, a great user interface, and some really nice probes that they've added to the portfolio to make applications easier. Really quickly, on the floor today, we're showing an RTC1000, which is an entry level, an RTB2000, an RTM3000, and an RTA4000. If it's hard to remember those digits and letters, just think of it as 1, 2, 3, 4. If you're in the scope market and you look at another competitor's 2000, Rohde & Schwarz now has an equivalent that we think you'll be very interested in using. You can think of the 3 and the 4000 as really targeted at R&D applications, designers working on embedded products, looking at power, whether it's big, whether it's small, looking at serial buses. The 2000 and the 1000 are more targeted toward education, universities, people with their first oscilloscope experience or with less challenging tests. So all of them share some wonderful DNA. The DNA that the 2, 3, and 4 all share is a 10-bit ADC. It's an ADC that was developed inside of Rohde & Schwarz specifically for oscilloscopes. Very low noise and again 4 times the vertical resolution. Those families also share the same user interface, so a company investing in one can quickly move to another one without any type of retraining and probing. Here's a real life example. I'm looking at a power rail. On the bottom, I'm looking at the measurement made with a traditional probe scope. The top, I'm looking at a much more pristine measurement with a power rail probe and a low noise scope from Rohde & Schwarz. Every embedded device has power rails in it. In fact, a phone has more than 100. All of these need to be tested. They're getting smaller with tighter tolerances.